Hi there. Today we're going to cook a couple Cornish hens on a rotisserie. For this one, I'm going to use the 12-inch rotisserie. There's what they look like. Catfish got nice crustacean. All right, so that's building up some heat pretty good. Been working out here in the back, working on that one of them down trees from the windstorm a month back or so ago, and got it about half hacked up, I guess. Some of it's the tree top and the other underbrush. It's pretty thick and nasty area, and I'm only getting a little bit of time to work on it. A couple hours this morning. About an hour last week until the chain messed up, but we're gonna start doing tonight's dinner. It's almost 1 o'clock now. I'm gonna shoot for about 3 hours, and I'm giving myself a little leeway. I don't want to eat too late tonight. Got to work tomorrow. My wife will be home around 5, so I'm gonna shoot for that. So I'm hoping to give it about 3 hours worth of rotisserie roasting and give myself a little buffer time in between. We had quite a bit of leftover food from yesterday's meal, the quinoa as well as the cimarron slaw. So those are going to be our accompanying sides with this. So all I'm going to film really is the Cornish hens, and we'll get started doing that real soon. Okay, so first things first, I want to make myself a little basting batter. To baste the Cornish hens in, I've got, I'm just winging this one, I've got some cilantro I'm going to chop up small, stick butter in the cooler. I'm going to also put a little bit of, this is a homemade Southwest seasoning. I found it online. It's, I think it's actually Emeralds Southwest seasoning if you go looking for it. Made this batch probably last year and it made quite a bit, so I'm going to use it up. Used to my other knife block where everything's in other order. So we're gonna just kind of rough chop this one. Now that's maybe a lot more than I want to use, but we'll find another use for some of the rest of it. Stick of butter. I'm going to use the whole stick. And
that ought to work. Also, I've got a couple cast iron cake pans that I am going to use as the Cornish hens. I'm going to just call it chicken. Just rolls off the tongue easier. But as they start dripping their juices and stuff, I just want to collect them. Not really sure how much of an area I'm going to need, so I've got the two pans for that. And I guess we'll go get the start. Okay, so here's what I did. I got the rotisserie, and I pre-measured the first fork tine, whatever you want to call it. So I'm going to, let's see where you guys at. Get my Cornish hens. I've got two of them. Total is about 1 3/4 pounds. Here, I would truss them, but I don't have any strength. I want to make sure there's nothing in there. All right, there is not. I want to pierce them with the rotisserie right underneath the ribs and that little joint right there. And then use the tines to hold them in place. Kind of like that right there. That way, yeah, better get over there. Not really puncturing him any, to speak of. Get through the back, but again, who really gets to eat the back? There. Alright. And then the same thing with the other one. Alright, so I got them on. They seem pretty secure. I went opposite ends with them, so legs on one this way, legs on this one the other way. This guy did not fare too good in the processing plant. He'll be alright. It's mostly across the back. So now I'm gonna go pretty heavy on the seasoning. Yay. I think some of it's going to cook off anyhow. Same on the other side when we get them out there. Alright, so, and how this one works, there's a nice round spindle here, which turns really easy, but it's square stock, so I can move it forward just enough, and then the square stock sits in a triangular groove, and then the weight of what you're cooking just holds it down, and then in little increments, we can turn it. And there we go, quarter after one. Okay, so here is what I have left over from the quinoa. That's still quite a bit. That's going to be more than the two of us are going to eat tonight. So what I'm going to do to reheat it, I think I'm just going to cut that in half and kind of make like a double boiler out of it. I know this is overkill. It's going to be far too big of a pot, but I've got a small grill space. So I'm going to put that half in this pot, put water in this pot, put it there, and heat it up over top of the fire. Might as well make use of the heat. And all right, so it's a little after four. These little guys are doing really good. They're all right. So these little guys are doing pretty good. The joints are getting really loose, so I'm thinking they're going to be done pretty soon. If not, they're done already. But it's pretty low temperature. I did lower it down a position or so as this is dying out, and I got the quinoa here now. That's going to heat up. And let the quinoa heat up. And should be dinner pretty soon. He is done. I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to raise these back up, get them up here so they can rest just a few minutes, and then use what left of the fire I got to finish heating up the quinoa. It's not quite the easiest thing to adjust, but
then I'll walk it up one more in a second. That's really what I was wanting to do. That way it didn't dry out.
Thank
you. More?
No.
Okay. Thank you, Ruthie.
Thank you.
Yep.
The
no, it's only half of it.
Okay. That's good stuff.
It is.
Yeah. You want a knife and a fork, right?
Yeah. So here we go, leftover quinoa, the endless leftover Cimarron slaw, and half of one of the Cornish hens. Now let's go see how we did. Did you try any?
No. I was raised to wait till everybody said.
Okay.
Trying to strangle yourself there? No, we
skin.
Need better, better, some better knives, baby.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Where is that? There it is.
These are kind of.
No.
I don't even know if I could cut myself with these. I won't try.
And it went the best part.
What? The leg?
No, the skin just fell off.
Oh.
Yeah, see?
Oh, it's done.
All the way done. Still juicy.
Good thing it's tender.
Mm. Oh, that's good. Mm-hmm. Smoke penetrated it pretty good.
Very good.
That's good.
Wait until the camera goes off so I can use my fingers. Mm.
Okay, just so she can eat, I'm going to say goodnight. I want to thank you for hanging out with me this afternoon, trying out the new rotisserie. And we'll see you next time. Well. that's really good.
Mm-hmm. And the slaw is tangier.